Taking a look at the brand new Star Wars The Black Series 6-inch Princess Leia Bespin Escape. Very cool figure. This is coming to US Targets as an exclusive and everywhere else in the world, literally eBay. Thanks for not telling us what the hell's going on in Hasbro. Very confusing. Just over 5 inches tall in terms of the height of this. Very cool looking figure with facial scan tech. We'll get a look at her in just a second. Very quickly, the box, as we said. Princess Leia Bespin Escape on the front. Some very nice Gregory Titus artwork there. Star Wars The Black Series and the usual kind of stuff on the side of the box. The printing, so forth, so on. UPC should you need it to get at your Target stores. We'll put a link in the description underneath for probably eBay. As that's the one of the place you might find this is scalped a little, I don't know. And there we go, Princess Leia. And just on the back of it, we've got some text if you want a freeze frame. And there you go. That's it. That's the packaging. So the figure itself is pretty damn good. And the reason why immediately is good is facial scan tech. Really, really well done. They've captured the skin tone and definitely that look that Carrie had in the movie. Just that very, at times, incredibly childlike innocence just on her face, just lost in this world of crazy Imperials and kissing Luke and Luke finding out it's her dad. And anyway, yes, very cool facial scan tech from a very cool movie. So they've really captured it well. The blaster looks absolutely ridiculously huge in her hands, but then again, it was. So I think it's pretty much to scale, maybe a little on the big side, but it doesn't look too ridiculous. But certainly it's kind of approaching that. It's a very large looking gun there for her to handle. Standard kind of blaster we've had before, nothing really too different, no chrome, no silver, nothing. Would it be nice, given this as an exclusive figure, to just, you know, the Target would be paying a little bit more for it. Maybe Hasbro could have extended a little bit more to add just a little touch of silver, chrome up the weapon, that would have been nice. Anyway, we don't get that. We get an all-in-one, nicely sculpted, it has to be said, kind of jumpsuit that she wears. And it's pretty damn good. They've done some nice layers and folds, and they've managed to capture what is a kind of yellowy white without it looking too nicotine stained. They've captured a nice kind of balance of colour. So the paint application is very good. And really nothing else to report on the figure. It just goes down to little white high heels that she has, which is kind of accurate to the movie. There's not much really going on. Nice folds and rumples here and there. And she's got these kind of padded pieces that she has. God knows the temperature that must have been filming in this giant nappy on the set. But pretty good in the terms of articulation on the angle there. So we can get a pretty good... She can actually hold the blaster pretty well. It's quite reasonable, so it looks pretty good. And again, the red lips and the eyes, the facial scan tech, just bring it on home. There is no weathering in the hair. There's nothing really added there, which I think is... They could have maybe... anyway, we get the pretzel bun there done nicely with a kind of softer plastic, but it works really well. And the colours kind of relatively match the hair that's on the head, so it doesn't look too out of place, but it's definitely a different, slightly different colour because it's slightly different plastic. And you see a slight difference. You might not see it here in the video, but trust me in hand, it's slightly different. But it's a very good figure. I really think it's all to do with this facial scan tech, and this is really, I think, reviving the line and interesting a lot of people. And Hasbro should be proud of the facial scan tech because it's damn good. But really not a lot I can talk about in this figure. It's pretty simple, straightforward, plenty of good articulation. We've got her head on a little ball joint up at the top there, so there's a fair bit of movement, not really so much back and forth. It's really just a complete rotation. There's no real hinge up there. Arms, as you can see, ball joint with a hinge up there, really no restrictions whatsoever, all pretty easily done. And they've sculpted it fairly well just at the tops of the arms, thinned that out a little bit to let it sit a little bit more fluidly against the body, which is always a good sign of a good design and sculpt. The elbows there have kind of like little kind of steps almost that kind of, they don't really quite click, but you get the idea, little kind of grooves, which allows the arm to not really get those kind of, and again, it's very hard to see white in the camera, but it allows the arm to not get kind of loose limbs, because those little steps and ridges kind of give that a little bit of solidity, which is good. Her upper ab crunch is a little bit limited because the kind of body and the padding that she's got on her doesn't really get it to move so much. So really that far back and about that far forward, so really not a lot, but I don't think most people will worry too much. Tons of articulation up at the top of the thigh. She's got a peg joint up there which just allows complete free movement. You've got an upper thigh swivel, double jointed knees, and down to pretty good rocking ankles with the tiniest little peg holes. Actually that looks pretty deep, but that one didn't. It looked a little bit more shallow. But yeah, it's right at the front of the shoe, so it's probably not going to hold too much. I really hope Hasbro gives some good stands. I was begging Steve Evans the other day when I saw the New York Comic Con Obi-Wan stand. I was like, stands, we're getting stands, finally. Give us some stands, man. Jesus, you've given us pickles and these things. She does stand fairly well, but you've got little dinky little feet, which it's... We need stands, okay? We need stands. But she does stand pretty well. There's no issue there, but that's only on a flat surface. So the minute you walk by, or if you've got a pet or something, or somebody bumps a cabinet, she's going to fall over just like all the figures. So, but great figure nonetheless. I definitely recommend you pick this one up if you're an Empire Classic Trilogy fan. I doubt you'll be disappointed. As to where it's going to be available outside of the US as yet, unfortunately, communications are really terrible. We have no idea. So you have to pay import costs or beg a friend, or as I did, pay a ridiculous amount of money to get this. And I mean a ridiculous amount of money to get this figure. So, yes, please help us, Hasbro. Just try and offer it to someone like BBTS or Darkside Toys or someone who ships reasonably around the world and we can get these figures. US, yeah, just giving it US targets, just such a pain. Anyway, let us know if this turns up for you in the UK or Europe or Australia, New Zealand, whatever, for exclusives. It would be very interesting to know. That's it from me. Link in the description below, as I said. And if you like this and other 6-inch figures, then join myself and Matt for the 6-inch show. I'm sure you know what it's all about by now. But if you don't, click subscribe and the little bell, and you will get great looking figures and discussions and stuff and photographs of cool looking figures straight into your inbox. We'll just see you for the next show and review coming up.